Okay, so feet shoulder width, weight evenly distributed within and between the feet, knees bent, tailbone sinking, spine straight, shoulders releasing, head suspending from above as though by a string. Feel into your feet. If doing that, you feel like your butt went out, you feel like your knees over straightened, you feel like you're leaning back. A lot of times people end up leaning back from the center of their spine a little. So from here down, pretty good, but then there's a little of that. You should naturally find the horizon in this position. So a lot of times we'll be getting into the standing and people will get into waiting. I wonder how long, it's about halfway through the room. Maybe the last few people don't need a lot of corrections and we'll start moving. Because your brain tells you this is what comes before the lesson. This is the lesson. And more than a few teachers just get me into standing posture and just say, let's do that for 6 months. Because if you can access the principles of these arts, then you get to meet your teacher. The teacher is not a human being, it's the principles. The person who's a human being that you write a check to, that person is pointing out what the principles are. So if you can get a sense of this, of a little improvement, a little more lengthening, a little bit more softening, a little bit more ease in the heart, in the brain, then you have an opportunity to get the lessons from the standing. And in thought, when I do it, and I do it every single class, do that for a moment, my teacher's in the room for like 2 seconds. At the end of the warm-ups, my teacher's in the room doing his stupid thing that he did all the time, right? Like, that's in my head, right? But still, to me, I do it, like, I was very clear on exactly when you keep things, how you throw them out, when you do it, how you test them. Like, I had this whole, like, the binder, the rules. And then I was like, I don't need the rules for this. I can just do this kind of, it's like putting incense on the altar for him. I can just see him doing it, and it doesn't hurt anybody. And maybe you love it, and you do feel it, and you think, I'm wrong now, you know. So maybe somebody gets something out of it. But I just thought I'd share, like, that's why I do that. Because he said, let's do it. And every time I do it, my teacher's with me. So, and he's not with me now, so it seems like a pretty cool thing. So, practice is to sink. Good. So, notice what I'm doing with the two smallest fingers, or the pinky and the ring. Okay, so the left goes on top, at the root, it crosses, root crosses root of those four fingers. Then the index finger of the lower right hand folds over the top of those two fingers. Now the two middle fingers touch by extending, almost, you know, like a little triangle out there. So that little triangle coming out from your center line should give you an idea for Collins and its logo. Okay. Now the heels of the palms, where they would meet under the pinky side, touch. But when I do it, and I do it every single class, do that for a moment, my teacher's in the room. For like 2 seconds, at the end of the warm-ups, my teacher's in the room doing his stupid thing that he did all the time, right? Like, that's in my head, right? But still, to me, I do it, like, I was very clear on exactly when you keep things, how you throw them out, when you do it, how you test them. Like, I had this whole, like, the binder, the rules. And then I was like, I don't need the rules for this. I can just do this kind of, it's like putting incense on the altar for him. I can just see him doing it, and it doesn't hurt anybody. And maybe you love it, and you do feel it, and you think, I'm wrong now, you know. So maybe somebody gets something out of it. But I just thought I'd share, like, that's why I do that. Because he said, let's do it. And every time I do it, my teacher's with me. So, and he's not with me now, so it seems like a pretty cool thing. So, practice is to sink. So, notice what I'm doing with the two smallest fingers, or the pinky and the ring. Okay, so the left goes on top, at the root, it crosses, root crosses root of those four fingers. Then the index finger of the lower right hand folds over the top of those two fingers. Now the two middle fingers touch by extending almost, you know, like a little triangle out there. So that little triangle coming out from your center line should give you an idea for Collins' next logo. Okay. Now the heels of the palms, where they would meet under the pinky side, touch. There's different power in the world than men. Right? Or muscle strength. This is a manifestation of an immense power. But it doesn't mean she can even help herself off the couch. Maybe she needs help with that. Right? Different power. So these are soft, loving, gentle, open, patient, receptive, old, unmuscled hands. The eyes are soft, at ease, alert, resting, heavy, open, soothed. And I look out into the world from those eyes with these hands in this breathing, connected to sky and sand. Open the sternum. Close the back. Close the sternum. Open the back. Open the sternum. Close the back. Looking at the horizon. Checking in on the alignment of your posture, the placement of the knees, the weight in the feet, the eyes on the horizon, the connection to the sky. If you're getting tired and you're thinking, I'm going to put these down for a second, ask yourself, what do you need to discard in order to be here for an hour? What would no longer serve you if you were going to be here for 7 hours? And at least give that a whirl for a minute. And then you might, I mean, you're grown up, you might literally have to put them down and shift your weight for a second. That's fine, I'm not going to bother you. You got to take, if you have to take a break, take a break. But don't just take a break because you thought of it. Inquire if you're holding more weight than you need. If something besides you is doing this practice. Because often if we set that down, we can hold the burden of the practice up. The people who quit, the ones doing the quitting aren't the people. It's the opinion, it's the personality, it's the thinking that that person did, that did the quitting. The person is life. And one thing I know that life doesn't do is quit. You are life. So you are that which does not quit. You may have quit before and you may quit again, but who did the quitting is not who you are.